really can't believe that we're to our soft opening, and this is a soft opening. We are not complete downstairs, so keep that in mind as you go through. We think we're finished enough that you're going to be impressed. We hope that you will be impressed. But there's been a lot of things go on below your feet the last 4 years, almost 4 years, and it really doesn't seem like it's been 4 years. But I want to give you just a little bit of a rundown of what has actually occurred downstairs the last 4 years. We have removed 2,300 tons of debris. I'm joking. You are so gullible. We applied 1,681 buckets of drywall mud.
Is that true?
No. The next one is pretty close to accurate. We took the original, we took all the subfloor out of the building. How many layers was it? Six?
Six layers.
Six layers of subfloor out of the building. We're down to the original hardwood floors from 1910. Okay? We pulled 2,391,681.2 nails out of that floor. We worked on that for weeks. We moved things down there in order to be able to have room to work 9,681 times. Right, Dean? We ate 6,281 cookies and 1,671 cups of coffee. You guys didn't know I was keeping this accounting, did you? And on top of everything else, we murdered, and those of you who know the space and knew that it was the City Hall before, we murdered 5,681,922.5 ladybugs. One of them got away, but they were injured during. Okay. We lost 681 pints of blood, but we never had a fist fight yet, and we never called 911. Thank you very much. Folks, that's all joking, of course. It has been a labor of love downstairs. We hope you appreciate what you see. Those of you who are familiar with what the space looked like before we started will hopefully appreciate the work that has been done. We completely rehabbed the thing. I can remember, I think it was in about 2010 or 2011, I hung a door or a sign on the door down there, the future home of the Space Museum Annex. It hung there so long it rotted. It is literally a miracle, seriously, that we have accomplished what we have accomplished. The original quote for just the rehab of the building was $170,000 or thereabout. That included air conditioning, flooring, yada, yada, yada. We are in at just under, you ready for this? Just under $40,000. Now, this was all provided by donations, and I must admit, much of that money came from internal in our organization. But that's okay. We believe in what we're doing. We have had other very good sponsors as well. That does not include the $22.5 million worth of space artifacts. The State Agency of Surplus Property has been incredibly helpful to us. Okay? But here's what I want to tell you. And I think every one of these gentlemen here, first of all, let me tell you this. The museum downstairs is about what these men are about. These guys are historical figures. They're icons. When they die, we are going to taxidermy them and put them up in the museum. They are artifacts on their own. We are collecting DNA right now so that whenever that becomes viable, we're going to clone them. They have been here, folks, nearly every weekend for the last going on 4 years. The youngest one is 84 years wise, and the oldest is 88. Can you believe it, Earl?
Yeah, I believe it.
Yeah. They've been here, but they represent the kind of spirit that took us to space in the first place, and that's what the museum is really all about. The artifacts are one thing, but they really represent what we as a country were able to do when people were passionate about a goal, were willing to work hard, commit to something, and allocate the resources. And we've done that downstairs. We've got a lot of help. We need more help. We want you to know it is our gift to the mineral area in our region. None of us, not one of us, especially Earl, he's crooked. We don't trust him with anyone. None of us have taken a dime out of this. Not a dime in wage. Everything goes back to the museum. We are spreading our influence. Yours truly was in Houston last year. I've been invited back this year, which is a total miracle. I don't believe that one. To present at the ExxonMobil Children's Festival. We entertained over 20,000 kids last year over a period of 3 days. We do that with schools all over. The museum has been mentioned on a Discovery Channel special, which we will discuss later. But at any rate, so we have built it. Now, where it goes from here really kind of depends on you. Good. We want you to, listen, I'm quite serious. We want you to exploit this. We want this to use this to your good favor. Obviously, the education is important, and we believe in that. I do shows all over the state and out of state, and I love it, and that's what we do. But folks, this can become a destination. Tammy, is there anything else like it in Missouri that you're aware of? No. Whether you believe in space or not, you believe in money, don't you? And these people that come here eat in your restaurants, live in your hotels, buy your gas, and sometimes steal things. But we want you to understand we have done this for the community. We believe in you. We believe in the spirit that has built it. And that's about all I got to say. Other than this, Missouri has a huge aerospace legacy. Most of you may have forgotten that. McDonnell Douglas, Charles Benoit, I think his first name was Charles, lived down around Ayrton. He was contemporary with the Orville and Wilbur Wright. He had the first aerospace or aeronautical store. He was from here in Missouri and had the first commercial airline out of Miami, Florida. Did you know that? Edwin Hubble, whom the Hubble Space Telescope is named after, guess where he's from?
Missouri.
Marshfield, Missouri. Yeah. There are several astronauts from here. The first parachute jump was in Missouri. So to make all that even longer, we don't have this done yet. By the way, we are not done. We're about 80% done. We'll be ready for the grand opening this fall in September. There will be placards throughout the museum. We don't have them up yet. But anytime you see this placard, that means that Missouri has been connected to that project. They'll be all over the place. You'll be able to scan a QR code and it will tell you about that project. Okay? So here's the deal, guys. It's been a miracle that we've done what we've done. There's a lot more to do. Just shoulder up with us. If you don't do anything else, just promote the thing. And when I come knocking on your door talking to you about the 25 for 25 program, which is an in-kind service, you donate to us $25 a month for 25 months. Most people just write a check. Please do. But when you do that, we're going to advertise for you downstairs. There may be exhibits in your honor. There will be placards. I'm sorry we don't have those up yet either. But there will be placards all around the museum, and we will hand out a flyer that says, visit these establishments. Okay? Sound cool to you? Okay, where's your checks?
In the mail.
Thank you. Okay, so with no further ado, the museum is open this afternoon for as long as you wish. It is free.
Dang it!
It is free. It is the annex. The little museum will continue to operate. That will be our resources and educational center. And it will also be devoted to cultural icons, the toys and things of the day. This is more of the technical thing. Now, one last thing. Lowell, Babette, John, stand up. He ruined it this morning. I had a sheet over the door. We were going to do the big reveal and let him know that we were naming the facility the Grissom Center. He walked right through it. This is the kind of company I can keep, folks. He didn't really notice it. I got disgusted, went out and pulled the sheet off. He went out and looked at the door. He was really excited. So it is devoted to the Grissom family. Gus Grissom was our second American astronaut. Lowell is the younger brother. He has opened more doors than I can tell you about. I am not bashful about throwing his name around. I owe him billions in royalties. But anyway, thank you. Let's give Lowell Grissom and his family a big hand. When we do our grand opening, we're going to have I don't know that Betty would make it. That's Gus's wife. But we're going to try to have the sons here, Scott and
Mark.
Thank you. Scott and Mark, and we'll have two or three astronauts here, some from Missouri, Linda Godwin for one. She's from Cape Girardeau. Dick Richards grew up down around Caledonia. We're going to have a guy here, Rob Kelso, who's a flight director that has great stories about the space shuttle toilet. So we're planning for this in September. We may be looking for sponsorship, but this could be a big deal for our community, folks. That's all I got.
Thank you.
Hey, will you tag me there? A little over? You're fired.